highly anticipated release of version 21 of the Oxygen suite of products has arrived. Here are some of the highlights of what's new in Oxygen 21. Since DITA is such a popular standard, improvements for DITA authors are always at the top of our list. For example, the DITA Reusable Components view now has a tiles style of layout, and there are some new filtering options to make it even easier to find the keys and components you want to insert. When inserting an image, you can edit its attributes and reference it using the keyref attribute. And the in-place attributes editor now includes a preview feature to help ensure that you are choosing the correct image. This feature is also available in the attributes view. Conditional processing attributes can now be specified using grouped values. This is intended for situations where an attribute applies to multiple specialized subcategories. Oxygen now comes bundled with the latest version of the DITA Open Toolkit Publishing Engine. WebAuthor, the innovative online authoring tool, was also greatly enhanced for this major release. For DITA documents, you now have a new DITA Keys Toolbar button that opens a dialog box where you can quickly find a particular key and easily insert a reference to it in your document. Now you have the ability to integrate WebAuthor with even more file repository services, such as Alfresco, Perforce Helix, and more. WebAuthor now includes a new document template for creating markdown documents, and a simple markdown editor with support for common markdown syntax rules and syntax highlighting. Numerous design improvements were implemented for working with tables. For example, it is now easy to move an entire row or column. And a table properties dialog box is available for DITA documents for configuring various table-related options. Numerous feature requests were implemented for the CSS-based PDF publishing engine. You now have the ability to add an edit link for each topic in the PDF output, and clicking this link will open the particular topic in WebAuthor where the user can suggest or make changes directly in the source. It is now possible to display tracked changes and comments in the PDF output. They are displayed both directly in the document and also in the comments section in Acrobat Reader. A lot of effort was put into making the JSON editing support as robust as other document types. The outline view is redesigned to work seamlessly with JSON documents, and it is automatically synchronized with the main editor. A more robust internal model is now featured. It displays the document structure even if the JSON content is not well formed, and validation errors are also shown in the outline view. Another major improvement was the addition of an intelligent JSON schema-driven content completion assistant. It offers proposals for quickly inserting JSON structures that are valid at the current editing location. Oxygen also includes support for using XSLT processing to transform JSON documents to various formats, such as HTML. As always, various features were added for XSLT and XQuery developers. For example, the content completion now offers proposals for options and functions, and documentation is provided in the side window for these options, as well as their values. New XPath 3.1 functions were added in the content completion, such as functions for maps and arrays. Similarly, the content completion in XQuery documents present new XPath 3.1 proposals, such as the various JSON functions. The Compile XSL Style Sheet for Saxon tool now allows you to set a Saxon configuration file for the compiling operation. These were just some of the numerous new features, updates, and implementations in Oxygen 21. For a complete list of all the additions, go to our What's New in Oxygen 21 page on our website.